My name's Anthony, and I drive a 2012 Stella 4T. And I have the balls to admit it.
Che vuole questa musica stasera? Che mi riporta un poco del passato. Io ti sentivo mia, soltanto mia, soltanto mia. Vorrei tenerti qui, vicino a me, adesso che fra noi non c'è più nulla. Sentila con le tue parole, quelle parole che non sento più. Il mondo intorno a noi non esisteva.
So I've had my motorcycle license since I was 18. And I didn't grow up in a family who was really supportive of motorcycles. My parents are terrified of them. Everyone in my family has a bad story, and you know, being a young kid, I was drawn to machines. I love cars, and when I couldn't afford a car, my mind naturally went to, oh, bike. Bike's cheap, right? And soon enough, common sense caught up with me, and I realized I can't afford a crotch rocket. I can't afford a street bike that I wanted. So I started thinking, well, what can I afford? And that's where like the vintage ideas started coming up. I don't know, it was just something about vintage Vespas that appealed to me. I knew they were goofy. I knew I wouldn't be able to get around, you know, efficiently on them. But I figured, how expensive could this scooter be? It looks cool, right? They were manual. When I heard that they were manual, that sold me right away. And I always knew that one day I would eventually own a vintage-esque Vespa. Of course, even though the previous owner put Vespa badging on, this is not a Vespa, it is a Stella. In North America, the only modern manual scooter you can buy is called a Stella. And Stella is just a North American brand under the Genuine Scooter Company, based out of India, somewhere in India. And those are like hot words that nobody wants to hear. Why does it say Vespa? It's made in India, right? Like, I get it. It's almost like sacrilege. But to understand why this is coming from India, you have to understand a lot more about Vespa as a brand. You know, when people think about Vespa, they're instantly drawn to Italy. They're instantly drawn to, you know, those beautiful scenes of a Vespa flying through cobblestone streets in between little European cars. And that is 100% accurate, right? Like, you know, old world cities in Italy, France, people ride these scooters around. But the parts for those scooters and a lot of the manufacturing took place in India, where labor was cheap and the parts could be made. The Genuine Scooter Company is actually a subsidiary of LML. LML is an Indian company who for decades has been making parts for Piaggio, the owners of Vespa. And so when the 1980s PX blueprints slot were out of their trademark, guess who picked them up? The people who were making the parts. And these things sold like crazy in other countries outside of North America. And that's why it's kind of weird. When I drive it around in Toronto, the majority of people who identify with this scooter are either like really young Indian people or really old Italian people. You had in the 1960s, 70s, and 80s, the Vespa represented mobile transportation and small compact transportation for Italy, for the country. In sort of the same way that the Fiat 500 did. It was the people's method of transportation. LML, as a company, was able to take that and repurpose it in another country that was going through an industrial revolution where they needed scooters to get from, you know, place to place. And so that's all resembled in the kind of people that identify with this bike. Once the four-stroke engine came out, it was finally allowed to be imported into Canada. And there was a place downtown Toronto called Motoretta who was importing them. And in 2013, I walked into Motoretta and I thought I was going to walk out of there with one of these until they told me exactly how much they wanted for it. And then I was like, no, I cannot afford this. So, you know, back in 2013, it's like my dreams of ever owning a Vespa went out the window. Of course, I now own one, and I now realize how much fun they are and what they mean to me personally. I gotta say, one of like the most rewarding things about riding this bike is the people who come up and have conversations with you about it. I think there's a big perception about motorcyclists and people who ride bikes that, you know, they're scary or they're up to no good, they're evading police or whatever, and it's a stereotype. You don't get that with this. This is so much more goofy and fun, you know, and lovable. So the people who end up coming up to you are people who they're happy to see a scooter. And the most common is usually older Italian men who come up to me in the middle of a parking lot and they're like, "Oh, I remember I rode all the way from Sicily to..." I never remember the exact place, but these specific areas, and they cover the entire country on a Vespa. And they tell me these stories. They're very elaborate stories. Whether or not they're true, who knows? But it's sort of embedded in their collective conscience. And the one thing that I always take away from that is that this reminds them of their youth. This resembles youth to them. This is what, you know, this is what they think about now in their old age. And that's why they love to see it. As a young man myself, you know, that's what makes me enjoy riding it, is that, yeah, I'm not going to keep this thing forever. It's ridiculous. It maxes out at 88. The tires are 12 inches off the ground. It's not a practical motorcycle in any way. But if there was ever a time for me to ride it, it would be now, as my first bike, right? Yes, it's not a real Vespa. It's a Stella. But it's made with the same blueprints. And because it's made with the same blueprints, it's made in the same essence. You know, when you start pulling the fenders off this thing, you see the same thing that is on a 1980s PX. You see the little battery wedged in between the spare tire that sits on the left side of the bike. And on the other side is the engine. So when you're sitting, you're sort of off kilter, but it's natural, right? You have four gears. So clutches here, first, second, third, fourth. It's to most motorcycle riders, like, and I've talked to people about this, they're like flabbergasted. It's like, what do you mean you shift up there? Isn't that awkward? It is the most simple and like user-friendly thing in the world. Until you try it, you won't know. And that's the thing. This design is as beautiful as the original Fiat 500. It was a people carrier. It was a multi-purpose tool more than it was, you know, a nice bike. It was something that they had to use for everything. And so they made it that way. They got more storage than any motorcycle I've seen, and it's all located right in the front. I love this thing. It's awesome. It's more than just a scooter.